guys, Tritons here. In today's video, we're gonna be hopping on the bandwagon and trying out this wet look trend we've seen on YouTube, but we're gonna be doing it on our natural hair.
Watch out, world, I'm grown now.
It came to my attention last night when I was watching videos on how to do it, that a lot of people have been doing it on weave. And I didn't realize that it wasn't their natural hair. But there have been some people do it on their natural hair, so that's the one I actually looked at to see some of the advice. I watched Aslia Williams' video, and she like recommended a couple of these products, but a couple of them are just ones I'm gonna try myself because I see that's what a lot of people are using when they use natural hair. So we're gonna be using a leave-in conditioner, a mousse, a gel, and a curl defining smoothie. So these
maybe
are gonna
be some oil.
Oh yeah, maybe some oil. This is gonna be like a 4-part process. All right, so just so you know what products we're using, in case you do decide you want to replicate this look, we are going to be using Lotta Body Wrap Me Foaming Mousse with coconut and shea oils, TGIN Leave-In Conditioner with green tea, super moist, and argan oil. So this lightweight. Lightweight is probably good because we're gonna have to be weighing down our hair with a ton of gel. And then this is, I'm pretty sure this is a newer product, I think. It's Shea Moisture Sacha Inchi Oil. Omega 369 Resue and Repair Pro Defining Smoothie with quinoa and Rose of Jericho extracts. How Shea Moisture get in some of these products, these ingredients, I do not know. But it'll probably be good on our hair. We both have type 4 hair, and I would be trying it. My hair I just recently braided it up, and I'm not about to mess it up or put no wet look on my hair. So we're going to be doing it on her hair. All right. So we probably should,
I'm going to be washing my hair tonight, too.
Yeah.
So in case this doesn't go that well, you know, it's fine.
Y'all probably can't. Is this a wet look? She should be doing it like as a wash and go. Because some people do it as a wash and go. They wet their hair first. But we're going to be doing it like this. We're going to put some water on her hair, just a little bit. But I feel like, at least in my opinion, it more makes sense to do the wet look if your hair isn't that wet. Like, because that's you're supposed to be replicating a look where it's supposed to look wet, but it's not actually that wet.
Because if you're gonna make a wet, might as well do a washing though. But not going to be doing that.
So let's cocktail. So this is our I don't think I mentioned the gel we're using. It's extreme wet line gel.
You could probably use Echo or something like that.
Yeah.
One reason we're also doing this is because we looked up the wet look online, and like the top looks were all of like girls with straight hair, like things like that. Not many top videos were on natural hair. And I think that, I feel like though that a lot of like natural hair girls would like to try something like this. You know, look, and I think a lot of other people just like to kind of see how it would turn out on hair just so.
Especially
they kind of kinky and coily like this.
Yeah. Because if we can get our hair, I mean, y'all know type 4 hair, you can get type 4 hair looking wavy, that's doing something because our hair is very naturally coily.
Right, like it's very, like it doesn't really have that many defined curls. I think that's why a lot of people want to do the wet look because that's going to like make the curls pop more. That's why like the other girls with straight hair, I don't really know what's up with this whole wavy hair, but it's like girls with straight hair are trying to get it into this middle as well, the wavy, and then girls with curlier hair. We're always trying to like go for that look when we do the wet look.
And it is pretty. But I mean, all hair is pretty. This is just for fun.
You can see she's cocktailing a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything I'm supposed to do? Like, I don't know. We're just gonna start kind of.
Yeah.
So no. She's got some foam.
You know, like we're gonna be pulled. Yeah, like we're gonna be going at this in sections. That's what it is. And we're gonna actually put some water on each section. Just a little bit of water too. So we're gonna. I'll do this half her head and she'll do the other half, and we're gonna kind of do like 4 sections. And then some people do use a brush, so we might use that as well.
I think it's like slipping off from there. My hair is actually kind of dry right now. I just took out of braids. And I should have oiled it more. Let me get some of the olive oil.
Oh yeah, that probably help add a little bit more nourishment.
It'll probably make a little more sheen
and prevent flaking up a little.
As you can see, if you want a slick ponytail, gel is great for that too.
I'm gonna get a little bit of this stuff back.
I'm gonna use a little bit of this, which is actually, it's called Jam, and it's a shine gel with an extra hold, and it really does have extra hold. I can't lie, it's not one of those things that just say that. It's very thick, like it's not even falling off my hand. It's really like a jam. I'm gonna take a little bit of that and add it. I think it'll make the curls pop a little quicker. I can already see that a little bit. Yeah.
Hope it's not too obvious that I'm going into this not quite knowing how to do this.
I've hardly even watched many videos.
Whew. Yeah.
It's something I always kind of thought about a little bit. Like, I tried finger coils once. Just trying to make it look more defined.
Yeah, so she's about to wash her hair anyway. It's okay to wear her hair down like this. Because at other times, we would not be okay putting all this product on our hair.
I think it's making my hair more heavy as well.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh my gosh. I was even like planning on doing all this. She convinced me.
Yeah.
It's making it heavy. You know what that means? Heavy hair means hair that's hanging a little longer.
Let me see if I can find like a brush. Definitely I've heard some about the Den Man brushes before talking about using that some. This is a comb.
Oh Lord, no.
But I'm not actually like running it through here. I was honestly running it on top of it. Not trying to cause breakage.
It'd be weird if my hair texture was actually more like this. I've already been told before that it looked blazing. And it's literally just because my eyes are skinny. People can say what they want, but that's really because my hair is like natural, like naturally very thick. And people will say that anyway. So like, I'm not taking it as an insult. Like, you know, I think Asian people are beautiful. But dang, you know. But if my hair was like this, I feel like people would definitely think, just assume that I was mixed with something.
Definitely using a lot of gel.
Oh God, look at my edges.
It's just tea.
Woo. I would definitely like to experiment more with like
no gel. Yes.
It's so much more easy to control.
Yes.
If you had a toothbrush, just lay them. Woo.
Alright, so I need to go ahead and hit up the back too.
We're gonna definitely be taking some pictures because
never
done this before. Yeah, we never done this before, like we're just very inexperienced, but we're showing you guys that it's kind of working. We're doing it for teenagers who don't really like. Oh, we don't know that much about all this. We're gonna try it anyway.
YouTube shows us a lot of this stuff, and we just go at it, you know? And being on summer break, the 1.5 more weeks we are, does give us time to try a mess like this.
And we're gonna, like, I'm gonna detangle it some. So I think you kind of take it apart and apply the curl even more.
Yeah, that's true. Instead of just matting it down.
I know. This is cool. This is weird. I feel like my hair is just hanging so, like, just like a. Like, I don't know. I know you guys are like, my hair hangs like this all the time. You know, that's natural. And like, if you're a black girl with natural 4C hair, you know, my hair tends to defy gravity.
So,
right. It goes out. Up,
yeah. Alright, so we actually did get a brush. This side is a little bit harder. So we're gonna. See just if it slicks it down even more. Right. I'm just like starting at the roots.
I don't know, y'all. You don't really have to do this part, but this does add a little bit more slickness if you really want a wet look. But y'all can like see right that side. It's getting pretty slick.
You guys, we could do an ASMR like this, you know, just brushing hair.
And then we could hit up the back a little bit bigger. We should take out the rings. Yeah.
I don't really brush my hair much anymore. Hurting.
Oh, it is. Yeah. Oof. I don't ever do her hair really. Not especially not like this. If I do her hair, it's a protective style. So this is different.
This is something in the camera.
This looks like a little exotic. Oh, that's funny.
I feel like my hair was like dyed too.
Yeah.
It's cute.
I expected, like you can see there is some shrinkage too, but that was expected. And it's because it's wet, so our hair just it shrinks a little.
But you guys can see overall, it kind of worked. I like it. It's mm-hmm. different. You can try some new things with your hair.
And the only reason that the back is looking a little dusty like it is just because we didn't completely put it on the back because their hair wasn't all the way out. So kind of if you ignore this part, this is how the wet look ultimately looks. But the back does add a little extra length.
So yeah, that's it. You can do multiple things with it if you really like it. Like, it's already good to go. The edges are already laid, so if you want to pull it into, like, a back ponytail, or just get so very slick.
Mm-hmm.
Very easy to manage and control.
This is adding the extra water on the top. It gets rid of a little bit of the white buildup. Look at that, y'all. Maybe I should get a close-up. Y'all want a close-up? All right, let's get a close-up. Right here.
This joint right here, it makes me wanna...
video. I like to call this like the more natural looking wet look because it does look more natural. She goes out, people aren't gonna like think that she weighed down her hair with product. It looks just like a looser texture.
Exactly. And I know one thing, you have to buy a lot of products, so if you don't have that much money, I don't know if you're gonna ever be able to really do the wet look because it has gel and curling custards and a lot of different things. It takes some time too. So thank you guys so much for watching. Mm-hmm. Don't forget to follow our blog.
Oh yeah.
Check out some of our other posts.
We'll put the links in the description. Instagram, subscribe. And-